everyone, it's Carolina from Gotta Love Polish. Welcome back to my channel and welcome if you're new. Today's video is an idea that I had after a couple of conversations with some nail polish friends, and also being inspired by Hillary from Mediocre Manny's and also Tori from Bits of Polish here on YouTube. So this video is my nail polish goals for 2024. I know. Crazy. I mentioned one or two of the nail polish goals that I had in comments in those videos and also in the conversations that I was having. I was talking about things that I would like to do for this year, and then my friend was like, that's a goal. Like, why don't you just make a video for nail polish goals? And I'm like, okay, I guess I will. So I'm making a video for nail polish goals. I rarely make nail polish goals for myself, and then usually I kind of forget about them. So then they don't work out for me at all. So this year I wrote down the nail polish goals that I want to talk about. I actually have a piece of paper here with my nail polish goals, and I wanted to share these goals to kind of be accountable, and I guess also just to see if maybe these goals can help you in your nail polish journey or in your nail polish goals for the year if you make goals. Honestly, I am not one of those people that like makes resolution anymore. I just know that they don't work out. If you want to change, you need to do it as soon as you want to do it. So these goals, even though I have them written down, are flexible. They will probably change throughout the year. But right now, this is what I want to try to focus on for me. If I feel that they're not working out for me, I will definitely stop trying to make these goals a reality and figure something else that may work out for me. And the same should be for you. You shouldn't just stick to some arbitrary goals that you think, oh, this is, sounds good. You should make and stick to goals that you want to achieve in your nail polish journey, and even in your life, like honestly, like that goes for anything. So I'm going to keep looking down just to make sure that I don't miss something, because that's another thing that I am very, very good at. I usually don't write my goals down and then I promptly forget them. I have really bad memory, y'all. I think people think that I'm playing when I say that. I used to suffer from severe migraines, and they gave me a medication that really worked to help with my migraines, but one of the side effects is memory loss. And I kid you not, I have memory loss. And yeah, it's a trip. I do forget things if I don't write them down. Certain things I can remember very strongly, and certain things it's gone. Like I don't know how to explain it. So my first nail polish goal for 2024 is go back to my favorite polishes of the year videos and see how many of those polishes I still own, and also if I still love them. So fun fact, and kind of a spoiler for future video, I have already started doing that. I went back to the first video I recorded for top polishes, and that was back in 2018. I actually pulled out those polishes. I got interrupted by my daughter, so I don't know where I left off. So I'm going to go with the part that I think I left off at. I have the polishes on my table. I have been slowly swatching them on my nails and getting better pictures of them. A lot of the pictures that I had of these polishes are older, kind of not a great quality, and not only that, some of them I don't even have pictures of. So when I started documenting my polishes, I had already worn these, and then I started doing YouTube videos again, and then I noticed that when I went back to try to find the polishes or the pictures of the polishes that were my favorite from 2018, I didn't have any pictures, like zero pictures. And I'm like, how could this be? And then I realized I wasn't documenting as consistently as I became later on. I honestly started my YouTube channel because once I started documenting my pictures on Instagram, kind of like a photo album for myself, that's how my Instagram started. And then I realized that I had so much to talk about for polishes and so much I wanted to share. I know, I'm a talker, I'm doing it now. But I wanted to start doing YouTube again, because I used to do YouTube before and I stopped, and now I wanted to start it again just so I can have more to talk about, basically, and also meet other people that have, you know, the similar interests that I do, which is what I always say. I love YouTube and Instagram nail polish community because we get to talk about our favorite subject. Number two, buy less dupes for myself. That's my goal. Everyone has colors that they're infatuated with. I am the same way. I tend to buy a lot of similar tones of purples, of blues, of greens, whatever. Whatever the color of the moment is for me, I will buy the same tones. And it's something that I already may have. Like, I have a big collection. I have 4 Helmers full to the brim of nail polish. So I have enough. And so I end up duping myself. And at first I was like okay with it because I can do comparisons video, yay! Because I love comparison videos, I thought this is great, but it's not so much for my wallet. It's not so much for the space that I have. I have a limited amount of space. And also not only that, but I just feel like I'm kind of wasting money at some point when I keep buying things that are similar to something I already have that I still haven't used up. It also makes me feel a little overwhelmed with the amount of polishes that I have. So I feel like 2024 is the year where I just want to take a closer look. I started a little bit in 2023, but in this year, I definitely want to take a closer look to my collection before I purchase anything. Goal number 3 is keeping track of how much I'm spending every month. That's a hard one. My husband actually made me an amazing tracker on Excel. I just put in the information and the price, and it calculates everything that I'm purchasing. I love it because I also have a section where I put the polish names, so that way I know what I bought when, because that's a big thing for me too. I always forget exactly when I bought something or whatever. I mean, that's not really that important for anything else. It's just something I enjoy doing. I like to know when I purchased a polish. How long has it been since I've had it, and have I worn it? But the reason why I want to do this tracking for me this year is because already in January, I'm recording this in January, I have spent a lot of money. Granted, I did do some destash, so it kind of balanced each other out. However, I bought more polishes. I destashed polishes and then bought more. You know, like, I don't know. So, and then I ended up spending a little bit more on the polishes that I bought than the destash itself. So it just feels kind of counterproductive to do this. And I'm not trying to be a negative Nancy here and say you shouldn't be buying polishes and you should do minimalistic stuff. That's not what I'm trying to say at all. I am not one of those people that feels like I have to like say, oh, well, if I'm doing it, you have to do it too. It's so great. Yeah, it's great for me. And it may not work for you. And if you have the finances to do it, the space to do it, and the drive to do it, then do it. Do what makes you happy. But for me, my collection is big enough that I should be happy and I should not be buying more things. So that's just something that I'm feeling this year. Again, subject to change. It may be in 6 months from now, I'm like, forget it. Let's just buy all the polishes. And it probably will, because I'm supposed to be going to Polish Beauty Expo this year. So maybe I'm feeling like that because I know that that's coming. I don't know. But the point is that I'm trying to keep track of how much I'm spending so that I can be better about not spending so much. Hasn't worked out so well this month, but hopefully in the future it will. Goal number 4 is destash. Destash, destash, destash. I am ready for some serious destashing. I have way too much polishes and I would rather they go to another home that maybe somebody will use them than staying here with me if I'm not gonna use them. My husband also made me a destash spreadsheet on Excel that calculates the money that I'm making, etc., etc. And it also helps me keep track of the polishes that have been sold and whatnot. I have a lot of polishes that I want to destash, and some of those polishes are probably not gonna sell. So I have decided that if my polishes do not sell after 6 months of being on the sell page, I am going to maybe do a giveaway with those polishes in the future, or I will have to find somewhere local to donate them to. Maybe like Goodwill. I used to give to a woman's shelter in my area. However, they no longer accept beauty products right now. So I don't know how long it's gonna last. They haven't accepted anything since 2020. So I don't know if they'll ever open up again to accepting things. So I have to find another method. I think Goodwill accepts polishes. I mean, the polishes are good. I wouldn't give away or sell polishes that are not working or workable. I just don't want them to sit around in my house collecting dust. If for no reason. And goal number 5 is actually kind of in the same vein of the de-stash goal, but this time it's for uncluttering my social medias. Okay, I wrote this down, so I'm gonna read it out to y'all. Because recently in a nail polish chat that I am part of, somebody found an account that they were not following, that they don't remember following, but they were following, and they also, you know, took a screenshot of that account, and my face was on it, and I'm like, I have no idea who this person is. Like, I have zero recollection following this account. It could be that they were a nail polish account at some point and they've changed, but I went through the account and I didn't see any photos. First of all, there wasn't a lot of photos on there, but I didn't see any photos that were like once nail polish related. Very, very, very rarely will I follow an account that's not nail polish related on my Gotta Love Polish Instagram, because that's my account for nail polish. And so 99.9% of the accounts that I follow on there are nail polish related. This was not a nail polish related account. This wasn't something I'm interested in. It looked like somebody's personal account. It kind of looked like a bot account, to be honest. I never auto follow anybody. Somebody follows me, I investigate their account. I see what they're doing with their account. And if they're not somebody that is doing nail polish or, you know, whatever, I don't follow back. I don't do that. So the fact that I was following this account, and I was, kind of freaked me out a little bit. I have been a victim of identity theft in the past. I've mentioned this before, and that's something that I'm never wanting to go through again. It's horrible. And so I would prefer to limit my social media accounts to things that I actually want to follow instead of just following 1,000 accounts. So I promptly went into Instagram and I found 6 accounts that I had no recollection of following. I had no recollection of seeing these pictures before or this person's bio or anything, like nothing. And I know I said that I have bad memory, I get it, but come on now, it's Instagram. I don't doom scroll for the most part. I don't auto follow. So the fact that I was following these 6 accounts that look like bot accounts, like they have like 6 to 8 pictures on there, and then like a, you know, and they were all posted around the same time. I don't do that. I don't know how it became a bot account. Maybe that's another thing. Maybe it became a bot account. I don't know how that works, but I just don't follow these type of accounts, and I found 6 of them and I was just like, no. So I unfollow, I block, get rid of them. I also went through, because I was already there, and I went through over 300 accounts at the time, and just unfollowed 300 accounts, over 300 accounts at this point. It was actually really fast. I just would click on the name, look at their account. If they weren't posting nail polish, I just unfollowed. If they haven't posted nail polish in over 2 years, I unfollow. If they were doing like maybe they were a mainstream account or something, I unfollow, because honestly, I'm trying to declutter, so I don't need to be bombarded with nail polish advertisements or people who swatch for a lot of nail polishes or a lot of nail polish companies. So I unfollowed a lot. I unfollowed over 300 accounts. I kid you not. I went from 900 and something to 600 and something accounts. I haven't gone through all of the lists of people who follow me. I just went through that amount and then I haven't gone back, but I want to do that again. I felt very good unfollowing all these people that I just wasn't interested in what they were putting out anymore, or if they were just dead accounts, I just unfollowed them. And actually that really helped with my feed. I am seeing people that I haven't seen in a really long time popping up on my feed on Instagram, and I'm like, wow, I haven't seen this person in forever. They were probably buried by these other accounts. So yeah, I just thought I would share that and say that's one of my goals, to de-stash nail polishes and to unclutter social media accounts. Just because I don't need to follow everything and everyone. I'm also going to do that with YouTube. I've done that already. I've started doing that. That one I felt really guilty about, because I know that subscribers help other channels. But honestly, in the same vein that it was with Instagram, I would go on YouTube, and sometimes I wouldn't see the people that I really like to watch, because so many of the accounts that I follow were posting videos on the same day or close enough to each other that sometimes I would miss a friend's video that I really wanted to watch, or I don't know. I don't have a lot of time to watch YouTube videos. So I want to watch the ones that I really, really like. So even though I support that, I just felt like I just needed to declutter. And I actually feel a lot better about the stuff on my YouTube as well, just because I don't have so many videos on my subscription page, then I can find the ones that I really want to watch. Right now, I just feel like I want to streamline a little bit more of my life. So that's it. Those are all the goals that I have to share with you all today for 2024. I hope you enjoyed this video. Let me know in the comments down below if you have any of the same goals, or if you have any goals for 2024. That would be really fun to talk about and to see what you are planning for this year. And as I've said previously, this is subject to change. I'm not going to be like, this is what I have to do no matter what. If I feel differently later on, I'll do whatever I want to do later on. It's my channel, it's my money to buy nail polishes, and I am just sharing with you all to see if maybe it helps you, or, you know, just to entertain you if you like to watch these kind of videos. So don't forget to like, comment, and subscribe, and I'll see you in my next one. Bye!